Today we are discussing 12th lab program, that is finding a square root using without using built-in function. So here there is one built-in function. There is one built-in function which is defined in mat.h. Why we use mat.h? Some of the functions are derived in this header file so that we are going to use them in our C program. It helps us in coding, reduce the length of the code. So here there is one built-in function called sqrt of 25. Any number. Okay na? Sqrt of 25. It means this function, this built-in function returns the result 5. Okay na? I am not writing any code to find out this 5. There is a one built-in function called square root. Use that one so that you are going to get the output. In this program also I am using sqrt. It doesn't mean that both are same. Got it? Both are different. This is just variable. SQRT is a variable. Am I using here like this? SQRT something like that? No. So here I am not using this function. But here I am showing what is the difference. So this is built-in function. If I use this one directly in one statement I can get the result. No need of writing all this code. Write one statement. The square root of the given number is equal to percentage F SQRT of n value. You will get directly. In one line, you can get output. But I am going to avoid that built-in function because they are given the condition. What is that? Without using built-in function. So, without using built-in function means you can find any logic. Got it? I am writing this logic. If you know other logics, you can write. Using for loop also, you can write. But there is different logic. Okay, now it is not compulsory that you have to write the same program. What I need? I want output. Okay, now you can use different logics. You know. Now, like that sqrt, there is another function called power function. Power of 2, 3. What do you mean by this? What do you mean by this? This is nothing but 2 power 3. What is the result? 2 into 2 into 2, 8. If you use this function also, directly it gives the result 8. I am not writing any code to find out the power. So use this function, you will get the output. Got it? So all these are derived in mat.h. So without using mat.h, without using built-in functions, you have to find out. So that's what we are doing today. Okay na? Now in this function, in this program, so header files you are going to declare. Then always the program execution starts with main function. So after that, first step is declaration of variables. So how many variables I need for this program? All should be declared first. So here I am using 3 variables. One is square root, second one is temp, and third one is n. All 3 are belongs to which data type? Float data type. So I am going to use the conversion code percentage f. Now here we are having 2 statements, printf and scanf. Printf, enter one number. Scanf, percentage d, ampersand n. You are going to read the n value through keyboard. Okay na? So once you enter the value, it means suppose consider you are going to find out the square root for 9. Got it? You are going to find out the square root for 9. So my n value is what?
9.
What is the square root of 9? 3. You have to get the answer. Okay now? So to find out this square root for this number, I am going for some logic here. So that is starting from here to here. Okay now? This much. Here you can find one while loop. Before that while loop, I am initializing the values. Okay, na? Initializing the values. What is the square root value? N by 2. Alba, sqrt is equal to n by 2. What is my n value?
9.
Divide here. N by 2 is equal to how much? 4.5 is assigned to
sqrt.
Understood? Sqrt is nothing but 9 divided by 2. The result is 4.5 is assigned to sqrt. Initial value set to sqrt. Next, another variable is the temp. I am setting the initial value for that also. What is that?
0.
So, my temp value is how much?
0.
So, 2 initial values are set now. Now, can I use while loop?
Yes, I can.
So, I am going to write the while loop here. While, some condition, write statements and then close it here. So, within while loop, how many statements are there?
2 statements are there.
Within while, 2 statements are there. It means, each time, when your while loop is true, these 2 statements will be executed. Each time. Okay na? First time we'll check while loop, whether it is true or not. See, first time I'm checking the while loop. What is the condition inside the while loop? Temp? temp not equal to SQRT. What is the value of temp?
Zero.
Whether 0 not equal to 4.5, true or false? Tell me.
True.
So first time the condition is true. So when this condition becomes true, which statements will execute? This one and this one. These two I am writing here. Okay, now these two I am writing here. Now execute the first statement. What is that? Temp is equal to square root. What is the square root value? 4.5. It is assigned to whom? First statement over. Second statement. N divided by square root plus square root divided by 2 is assigned to whom? SQRT. Can you substitute the values and tell me? N value is 9 divided by 4.5 plus 4.5 whole thing divided by 2. Now first you have to divide this. Divide and tell me now. 9 divided by 4.5, how much?
2
plus 4.5.
6.5
divided by 2.
3.25.
3.25. Then tell me some more digits. That's all. Okay. 3.250000. I take. Okay, now 60. It has flowed. Understood? So first iteration is over. Correct? This is assigned to whom?
SQRT.
This is assigned to SQRT. First iteration is over. Now we can observe that the temp value and SQRT value are updated. Correct? Previously temp value was how much? 0. Now it is 4.5. SQRT value was 4.5. Now it is
3.25.
These updated values you have to check in while loop second time. Understood? So first statement executed, second statement executed. Then control comes to while loop. Now in this while loop you have to check the updated values. Okay, now that is called second iteration. Second time I am checking the loop. Tell me the updated value of them. 4.5. Whether 4.5 is not equal to 3.25. Condition true or false?
True.
So condition true for second time. So that it is going to execute these two statements. Now who is assigned to whom?
M.
Square root is assigned to M. What is the square root value?
3.25
is assigned to M. Correct? Next, can you find out this value? N value is 9 divided by square root value 3.25 plus 3.25 whole thing divided by 2. First you divide this, then you add this, after that you divide this. 9 divided by 3.25 plus 3.25 divided by 2. Tell me
your
3.00. How many zeros?
2 0 2 0 9 6 9 6 1 5 1 5.
Okay, now you are going to get this value. Okay. Now updated values are set to square root and temp. Alva, this should be checked again in a while loop for the third time. So third time I am checking the values. Now what is the updated value of temp?
3.25
not equal to 3.009615. Whether condition true? Yes, condition true. So if this condition is true, we are going to update the values. So now SQRT becomes temp. SQRT means 3.009615 becomes temp. Okay, now you divide this. 9 divided by 3.009615 plus 3.009615 whole thing divided by 2.
3.4 0 1 5.
This is the updated value of temp and square. Once again put it in a while loop. Okay, now while loop will be checked with temp value. Temp value means 3.009615 not equal to 3.4 0 1 5. Whether condition true?
Both
are not equal. Condition true. Now values will be updated. This value becomes temp. 3.00015 becomes 10. Now can you calculate this? 9 divided by 3.00015 plus 3.0015 whole thing divided by 2. 3.00006 zeros. Okay, now this is fourth iteration. Fourth time. should be successful. Next, I am checking fifth time. Substitute the values. Temple is 3.4015 not equal to 3.60. Whether condition true or false?
True.
Because not equal, still not equal. Now what happens? That becomes square root becomes 10. Alba, square root means this becomes 10. Can you calculate and tell me the answer? 90 divided by 3. 3.000 plus 3.000 whole thing divided by 2. How much?
3.
You are going to get 3. Okay, na? Now update the values here. Sixth time I am updating the values. Okay, na? So 3.0000 not equal to 3.000. Whether true or false?
False.
So condition become false. Once the condition become false, whether these two statements will be executed? No. So this statement will not execute, this statement will not execute. So it is going to terminate the while loop. Have you got the answer?
Yes.
What is your answer?
3.00.
That you are going to print it here. The square root of the given number 9, because the percentage Jacobian, is equal to this much. In which variable it is stored? Result?
Square root.
Okay, now print the square root. That's all. Easy one, right?